Next on Sky Movies, Wings Hauser is the undercover agent for the CIA, who escapes the hit squad of a powerful drug syndicate. His family doesn't, though, and his desire for revenge becomes an obsession. That's No Safe Haven. Non-stop action after the break.
Coming to Sky Movies, the big names, the big movies. Stallone returns and there's no stopping him.
I want you to know up front that if you're captured, we'll deny any participation or even knowledge of your existence.
Sounds familiar.
What some men call hell, he calls home.
Who are you?
Worst nightmare.
Sylvester Stallone, Rambo 3.
I wish I were big.
Tom Hanks in the box office smash.
I want to spend the night with you.
Do you mean sleep over?
Well, yeah.
Okay. But I get to be on top.
Big. He's been programmed to uphold the law.
Thank you for your cooperation.
And the law needs all the help it can get.
Your move, creep.
RoboCop. The future of law enforcement is here. Bette Midler and Lily Tomlin together with Bette Midler and Lily Tomlin.
God, it's me with a bad haircut.
I paid $12 for this.
In a comedy with one big surprise after another. Big Business.
The first casualty of war is innocence. The first real film about the war in Vietnam is Platoon.
Michael Keaton is turning the underworld upside down.
It's showtime.
The movie that puts life into the afterlife.
What do you think of this?
Beetlejuice. The year is 2019, and the highest rating television show in history pits man against man to the death.
Perfect contestant.
I want him.
Schwarzenegger in a deadly game of cat and mouse.
I'll be back.
Running for his life in a show where there is no winner.
How about the light?
Arnold Schwarzenegger is the running man. Step into a wondrous adventure. Come on a magical musical journey into the world of Michael Jackson. This is the world of Moonwalker. Buster is a family man.
It's Christmas time.
A dreamer.
Ain't no one gonna touch us now, Mum. We got it made.
And a thief.
I do borrow from banks. I mean, that is my job.
I mean, with their permission.
Phil Collins and Julie Walters in a comedy that'll steal your heart. Buster. A world gone mad. A child alone. From master filmmaker Steven Spielberg, Empire of the Sun. Jack Nicholson and Meryl Streep as you've never seen them before.
I ain't half bad once you get to know me.
Ironweed. What began as a holiday became a nightmare in the city of dreams.
You want your wife back, you'll get my suitcase.
Harrison Ford on a new kind of crusade. Frantic. William Hurt and Holly Hunter. Broadcast news. Freddy's here, and the terror begins.
Whatever you do, don't fall asleep.
A nightmare on Elm Street. Kevin Costner and Gene Hackman, No Way Out. Danny DeVito and Billy Crystal.
You lied to me!
Throw Mama from the Train. Plus, live and exclusive, Hollywood's Night of Nights. Sky Movies proudly presents the 62nd Annual Academy Awards. Only the big movies. Only the best movies. Only on Sky Movies.
Twenty years ago, America's finest were called to do battle in Vietnam.
Gentlemen, you depart today to fight the forces of godless communism.
They were young, brave men. They were husbands, sons, fathers. Many would never return. Others came home with painful, anguished memories. But now, a generation later, the time has surely come to unite and heal.
Good luck, and go with God.
Graves County, Kentucky, in the heartland of America.
And it's up to you.
Award-winning author Bobby Ann Mason grew up here. She called this place Hopewell in her best-selling novel, In Country. Now a major motion picture starring Bruce Willis and Emily Lloyd.
The future of America.
Everybody ready?
Come on, Larry!
One, two, everybody say, savage!
In Country is the touching, contemporary story of Samantha Hughes. She seeks to come to terms with a war that rages in the hearts of those she loves. Sam's Uncle Emmett is a Vietnam veteran, still haunted by his tour of duty in Southeast Asia.
Doing her job. Feel smart?
I feel like I could fly. Now, come on.
All right, family.
In Country is the story of one family's struggle to unite and heal.
Gotcha.
That's great.
For award-winning director Norman Jewison, In Country is his first film since the hit Moonstruck.
All right, now say cheese.
Oh, for God's sake. Oh, hey, cheese.
We're very close, I think, to the very roots of the characters in Bobby M. Mason's book, and we're in the heartland of America. Surely, if we're going to examine this country and examine its citizens, surely this is where we belong.
Sam is obsessed with a father she never knew. He was killed in Vietnam before she was born.
You, Miss Watergate. E.T. The Bruce Springsteen concert. God, you miss everything. And you were just a country boy.
You know, this is like rituals in the film where she puts the letters out and looks at him and talks to him, you know. Not to the point of madness, but, you know, that the eyes are just my daddy and everything. And, you know, every time she talks about him, it's like a part that's... It's the untouchable. That's why, I guess, all the unspoken, that's why she likes speaking, talking about it.
Well, can you tell me how he died?
Oh, they don't tell you that, Sam. They just...
Sam's mother, Irene, is played by Joan Allen. Irene won't talk to Sam about the husband she lost, the father Sam never knew.
You know about these?
Sam's discovery of her father's letters from the front meets with stony silence from her Uncle Emmett. To talk about the war is just too painful. Emmett is a wounded soul. He can't escape the tormented memories of his tour of duty in Southeast Asia.
He writes like a kid.
Yeah. That was us. Bunch of little kids out in the jungle, didn't know diddly shit.
Hard to read. What's a click and what's a bouncing booby?
Bouncing Betty.
Well, what is it?
Cake recipe. You ain't never gonna understand it. You don't want to.
Emmett,
just
what
burn
are
that
you...
damn letter, Sam. Just forget all about that damn shit. You're prying into something you ain't never gonna understand.
Just
leave it alone.
Well, what was in them to make you feel so bad, Emmett? God, they're mostly just love letters.
Incoming, Emmett. Watch your ass, buddy.
Damn it.
Emmett, are you all right?
Yes, I'm all right.
This was the first time in anything that I've done on film where I didn't really know what I was going to do prior to actually shooting it. Most of the other films that I've done, I've had a fairly good idea of what I wanted to do, you know, with the character and what jokes needed to be told, if that was called for, you know, what emotions, you know, had to be there. And I knew where to find those emotions and how to get to them. And I dealt with some things on this film that weren't that easy. I didn't know where I was going to find it. And I really relied a lot on Norman for that.
And I could see that he was so deeply committed to it personally. As an actor, but also as an individual, as an American, as a citizen.
You want to dance before you grow roots? Come on, Emmett. Come on.
Stop it now.
In Country's story of uniting to heal became the real-life story of dozens of Graves County vets who appear as themselves in the film.
When the movie came in, it pulled all the people together and said Vietnam vets are worth something. So we've enjoyed the atmosphere of the movie people, and the movie people in the town have really helped settle the town down as far as Vietnam vets. And we found that a lot of guys were our next-door neighbors that were Vietnam vets, and we didn't even know it.
It's been a summer of reaching out and coming together here in Hopewell. The vets' families cheer them on in a sandlot match against the cast and crew of In Country. On the sidelines, Hopewell's finest cheers on her home team. And around here, the man on the mound is now called Emmett.
Bruce himself has been a real good effect on the Vietnam vets because he called a meeting together early with us, and he got to know us. And once he gets into character on the set, he remains in character. He's really good at it, and he's convincing as a Vietnam vet. He really is.
Oh, look, there it is.
The film, of course, builds constantly towards that odyssey that she goes on at the end of the film, the last two reels of the film, where they get in that little Volkswagen and they go to Washington and they go to the wall. The wall, the Vietnam Memorial in Washington, has become the Wailing Wall of America. This is a sad place, but it's also a place where you leave your sadness and go on.
Stay tuned to what's happening on Sky Movies with a regular look ahead to our highlights for the coming week. It's on every Thursday night at 20 to 10 with a repeat on Sunday night at 20 to 8. Projector every week on Sky Movies.
This is Sky Movies.
Tuesday at 8. Tune into an evening of nostalgia.
Start every day the relaxed way.
I don't know what to do, Rabbi. Every night he listens to the radio.
Family life during World War II as seen through the eyes and ears of a boy.
Japanese have bombed Pearl Harbor. Earlier this morning, a surprise attack was made on our naval base with enormous casualties to the United States.
Remember, if we see any German planes, I do have a number to call, okay?
Beware, evildoers, wherever you are!
From Woody Allen, Sky Movies brings you...
I know what I'm doing!
Radio Days, Tuesday at 8.
The following movie has been classified 18, suitable only for persons of 18 years and over.